So, you are not dead after all.
I sharpened my wit, my wardrobe, and my eye, and I made myself the most terrifying creature in any room I entered. You can speak.
I have managed to keep the details of your return quiet, but when those vulgar mamas discover that there is an eligible duke present at tonight's fete, I shall be able to keep such a secret no longer.
That is what I was hoping to discuss. I've only returned to London to deal with my late father's affairs. I'm afraid it leaves me no time to socialize. I must ask you to accept my regrets.
Your regrets are denied.
They are off to a slow start, but I have hopes on bloodshed yet.
How adventurous, Colin.
Oh, God.
Too late. I already noted you.
Lady Danbury.
Well, do not make haste on our account.
You come from warriors. We win. Never forget that.
Neither, it appears, is your ability to somehow hear every piece of gossip that transpires in this town.
When will you accept it? I know all.
Could you move?
What are you doing in here, Lady Danbury?
I am going in, Your Grace.
No place for a lady in there.
Someone must be with her. If not her husband, then...
Would it pain you to wear some colour, Your Grace? The London season is already terribly monotonous as it is. Must your wardrobe do the same?
It's much too cold. Where's any sense of the subject's spirit? And the light? Given the quality, I do wonder why the piece was not skied with the other daubs.
Perhaps we should ask the artist.
Well, that would be something, Lady Danbury. Mm.
Mr. Granville, why was your piece not skied?
Mr. Granville, if you will excuse me, I must buy my wife.
You diabolical... How could you let me rattle on like that?
How could I not, my dear Mr. Bridgerton? It was riotously funny, you must admit. Is there a reason I've yet to see you on the dance floor?
All in good time, Lady Danbury.
Poor thing. Did you bring the bar with you, boy? The young lady is as rare a treasure as there is. Do try not to bungle it up. Thank you. I would tell you it's been lovely spending all this time with you, Your Grace, but I tend to leave such sycophantic behavior for the rest of the time.
You are my worst failure.
I beg your pardon.
I am sure you do.
I shan't again. Might I remind you that this boy is to be the next Duke of Hastings, and that he requires whatever reserves of fatherly nature reside in that frigid heart of yours.
Kate, dear, mm-hmm. Might Newton require a walk before he makes his mess all over these fine carpets?
Indeed.
Lady Danbury.
Ah!
So just the two of you stay on opposite sides of the room at all times.
Lady Danbury!
Apologies, Lady Danbury, but I believe it's time for me to go.
You fool. I'm sure you will abscond to some remote corner of the world and continue to do what you have always done.
And what would that be?
Take everything you have for granted. The young man I have always taken pride in raising well. I would have expected more. More discernment, more understanding, more appreciation.
Lady Danbury.
You allowed that young lady to slip through your fingers as if it were nothing. I understand that you believe such subjects as love and devotion, affection and attachment, you find it all trite and frivolous. But have you any idea? Those very things are precisely what have allowed a new day to begin to dawn in this society. Look at our queen. Look at our king, look at their marriage, look at everything it is doing for us, allowing us to become. We were two separate societies, divided by color, until a king fell in love with one of us. Love, Your Grace, conquers all.
What was this tea about, girl?
This tea?
You are being purposely obstructive, Agatha, and I will not have it. Excuse me?
Lady Danbury. That is my title, Your Highness. The one you were kind enough to bestow upon me. Lady Agatha Danbury.
You are living under my roof, under my care, relying on my good name, my connections, my money.
Are you so miserable, my lady?
I beg your pardon?
Are you not alone yourself? I watch you, I see you, you are more than content.
Because I have lived a life. You are not me. And if you continue down this road, you most certainly never will be. After passion cools and fate intervenes, who else is a woman left with but herself? Be honest with your sister, with yourself. You must tell her how you feel.
About my dislike for the Viscount.
About whatever it is you feel. I am going inside. Careful, or you shall catch a chill. Only a fool would jeopardize the marriage now. So I ask you, Miss Sharma, are you that fool?
Straight into the fire, a favorite pastime of mine.
What a surprise to see you here.
You do know my family has its very own room here. Yes, Lady Cowper?
Over there, is it not?
The one with the Danbury name, just above.
My lady, we are done.
We are done.
And in my loathing, I fund a school to seek revenge and satisfaction in me. Herman rots. Your heart is full. Mine starves. So when I called you fortunate, it is because you are.
I cannot marry you, but only because I cannot marry anyone.